Later tonight, Michigan will take on Villanova for the national championship, Sam. It's the biggest game in recent history, and they're facing quite the challenge in the Wildcats. The Wildcats offense is just a three-point shooting specialty. They have the NCAA record 454 triples this season. They average 11.6 makes per game. They average 29 attempts per game. They are the highest scoring team in the land. I mean, they just bring it all against this Michigan defense, and Michigan really just has the toughest challenge ahead of them so far this season.
Yeah, I don't think there's any doubt. You know, you look at the weaponry for Villanova. I mean, you got six players in double figures. You got multiple guys, three guys shooting over 40% from three, another couple shooting 39% from three. They're a low-volume three-point shooter. We talked about it. And Pascal, he goes out and goes 4 for 5 from three against Kansas. So, I mean, they blitz you. And that's, to me, a big, big point of emphasis is don't get hit by the blitz, like in football. I mean, you know, you look back at one of the teams that beat them in the regular season was Butler. Butler saw him again, and I think it was the one that they lost in the Big East tournament. You know, Butler was down 16-2 in the blink of an eye. I mean, this team, they can score quickly. They just hit you with a barrage. And so that Kansas game essentially was over in the first half. I mean, they, 13 threes in the first half of that game. It was over. So you're left trying to figure out, do you try to double team Jalen Brunson? Jalen Brunson is the player of the year. And the thing that I noticed in the Kansas game that I think Michigan is going to have to avoid is Jalen Brunson was working in the post. Now, I talked to a few scouts, a couple coaches. You know, they all rave about his ability in the post. We know he can shoot it. We know he can drive to the rim. You know, one basketball guy I talked to called Jalen Brunson the best post player in the country. Well, Kansas chose to double team him, and he carved him up passing out of the post, hitting those open shooters for three. So, you know, it's a pick your poison kind of thing. You have a veteran team. You have a team that they will come out and they'll give you a little intimidation as well, but they're human. And so I think one of the things that will work to Michigan's benefit is since last year, going back to that, we keep pointing to that Ohio State game where Michigan's defense really picked up. Their specialty has been limiting three-point attempts. Mm-hmm. You know, it's three-point shooting percentage is one thing, but limit the attempts. And so they have done a better job. I mean, you look at Loyola, 10 three-point attempts. I think that's going to be one of the keys for Michigan.
Yeah, I mean, if you look at, we were actually breaking down Villanova's schedule in the games that they won that were just in low-scoring affair or that in their losses, you really saw that at a team where they were taking around, let's say, 22, 24 attempts a game, those are the games that they struggled. And this is a team that averages 29 attempts per game. Last night, on Saturday night, they shot 18 for 40 in that win against Kansas. So it really looks like you said that three-point defense limit those attempts, and Michigan has a shot here.
Yeah, because here's the thing. I mean, you have to hope that they aren't just really just that dialed in, because this is a team, it doesn't matter if you're in their space. I mean, you could be up in their shorts and they will shoot it. They shoot the ball with no conscience. They shoot it like you aren't there. So, I mean, you can't let your defensive intensity, you can't let your closeouts be affected by how effective they are, you know, shooting the basketball, because they're going to keep shooting it. To me, if you can run them off the three-point line, and sometimes, hey man, that might compromise you going to the basket, you know, with hard closeouts, you know, but try to run them off that free throw or that three-point line, rely on your defensive rotations to be there. And if they beat you going to the rim, then they beat you going to the rim. But I think on balance, you live with some of that two-point efficiency more than you can that three-point efficiency. So I think they play them straight up. You know, I think they're going to do a lot of switching. But I do not think that you'll see, some of the struggles that we saw in the Kansas game that were born of them, you know, overplaying Jalen Brunson. If Jalen Brunson gets, you know, 25, I mean, you got to live. This is one of those pick your poison games. You're going to have to live with certain things. You're going to have to live with them with their no conscience three-point shooting. You're going to have to live with Jalen Brunson maybe getting his and try to limit three-point attempts. That, to me, is the key stat for Michigan.
Like you said, and they also got to hope they don't go in.
Right.
And Michigan's a team, as a year, they've held their opponents to 32.7% from three-point range. And most of those losses from Villanova, that's about the rate they were making their shots. So that's going to be a key stat to look at this evening. And then also, I think one of the other factors that people aren't really talking about, and we were talking about with some of the guys inside, is that Villanova has six guys on this team with experience that have a national championship ring. I mean, that's a clear advantage in this game.
There's no doubt. One of the first things I said is their experience. So the magnitude of the moment won't get them. You hope that whether it's fatigue or being in the Final Four, whatever it was that affected Michigan offensively, everyone other than Mo, JP, you hope that they've gotten that out of their systems, because they got to make shots in this game. This is not, we talked about how Michigan could win in different ways, and they have. They've won in different ways all along, whether it was great defense, key bench performances, one player going off. This is one of those games where it all has to be going. They got to be dialed in defensively. They need good bench contributions. They're starters. They all have to be on point. Everything has to click in this game, because this team is too good. This team is too, they're, you got to make shots. I think personally, they have absolutely no chance of this game being in the 60s. I mean, there was some talk, hey, if Michigan can keep it in the 60s, Michigan doesn't play. I mean, you can do a low possession, low scoring game a couple of different ways. You can certainly play a low tempo game and bleed the clock.
Right.
You can try to do that, but that's not how Michigan plays. That's not their natural inclination. I mean, the other thing is you could just play lights out defense and keep it in the 60s, but you aren't going to defend this team that way. So to me, the game is at least in the 70s. And, maybe if Michigan can make, and they play games like that at Purdue. That was a tremendous offensive display on both sides. Michigan just couldn't make any stops down the stretch. This is one of those games where I think it's going to be in the 70s or 80s, and they're going to have to make one more stop than the opposition. That, to me, is the recipe. But I just don't think you're going to be able to clamp this team down with the way that they can shoot it, the way they share the basketball. I mean, you look at Jalen Brunson, you aren't going to shake him off of his game. You can hope that he shoots it poorly, but he does so many other things. He rebounds. He's a catalyst, not just off the dribble, but in the post. There are just so many weapons on this team. I just don't think you go into this game expecting to limit them in that way. You can try to contain them a little bit, try to keep them off of their 87 points a game that they're averaging. But you're going to have to make buckets in this game to win. There's just no other way around. There's no way around it.
Well, we'll see later tonight if Michigan can get it done.